Hello, everybody. Thank you for joining me. My name is Carlos. Today, we're going to be going over and reviewing the back session for this week. Also, some delts, triceps, calves, and abdominals. So that's the routine today. Started off with the back row. Now, this exercise, one of my favorites for sure. Haven't been doing it until fairly recently. I had backed off, pardon the pun, these back rows for quite a while. Been doing mostly cables and deadlifts and stuff like that. But the back row had taken a back seat. Excuse me, the pun, man. What is it with these weak back puns? Anyways, the back row, been progressing pretty damn quickly on this. The last few sessions, we started out at two plates, went up to 245 with the rep progression and all that. And then the last week jumped up to 130 kilos, I think it was. Felt pretty easy. And today, zoomed up to 140 kilos. Now, I've received a few comments. I mean, it's not like the strictest. It's not like a board hanging, like, completely stiff and just like rowing like a robot or something like that. No, there is some leeway, there is some body English, and there is some posterior chain involved. When you get with these heavier weights with the back row, in my opinion, this is what works. If you want to get strong at it, if you want to stay, strict, ultra strict form, I really doubt that you're ever going to hit these like heavier weights, never going to get up to 400 pounds, that's for sure. So a little bit of latitude, a little bit of leeway is absolutely, required. It's legit. There's no problem in doing this. If I paid attention to everybody on the internet about, the strict form, I pay attention to Chad Nichols. That's who I pay attention to. I'm not being personally trained by him, but, I'm piggybacking on all his information. So according to the master trainer himself, intensity trumps form. And it's, what do you mean by that? How can that happen? How is this true? He says, well, yeah, because muscle and muscle density is built through heavy weight. And if you're a stickler for like super strict form, you will never progress with those weights. You won't, because you'll run into the issue that you will have to use a little bit of body English. And if that's taboo for you, if that's something that's forbidden, for prohibited, you bound yourself to these rules, then it's going to be very hard for you to progress with weight. sometimes you have to lift ugly, some sloppiness, whatever, as long as you don't get hurt. Now, everybody says you can get hurt. Well, guys, I've been doing this for a little while, and I've never, ever, ever been hurt. I've done some pretty heavy, crazy shit, and thank God above, I haven't run into serious issues. I've had some minor tears here and there, and it was always because I did not warm up properly. And warm up properly does not mean doing the weight, lifting the exercise. It means getting your core body temperature up, which means spending 15 minutes on the treadmill before starting a workout session, before starting weights. So today with the back row, felt really strong with the pull. I think I got 5 reps with the 3 plates. And, I definitely see myself going up to 335 and then, 365. Once I hit my limit, because there is a limit there, I'm pretty darn close to it, where, I can't even yank one off the floor, then it's time to pull the weight back a little bit and go for deadlifts now, which I think I might be doing on the next session. I really want to hit a deadlift PR pretty soon, because those 3 plates felt so easy that I figure if I could put one more plate and maybe a 10 kilo on each side and go for a deadlift rep, right? Go for 4, 5, 6, I don't know. So that was that. I did a back offset also with 110 kilos, and that felt super easy. That's the thing. When you hit these maximum weights and you do a back offset, man, that back offset feels a lot easier just to go for reps. And I did hit a PR there. I'd never done 10 reps with 110 kilos, and it felt pretty darn easy. So that was great fun. Then from there, I went to the one arm low row cable, which we're still, progressing at. Got 9 reps on that. Gonna have to go up to 209 pounds on the next one. It's feeling more manageable. Like the last session, I was kind of flopping around. It was, it was hard to control. And, you know, today it was much easier. So, you know, practicing, this is, you have to practice with these weights to get good at them. And if you're always doing sub, you know, sub maximal weights, well, it's really hard to get good at lifting the heavy stuff. Like, you know, you're never going to hit a 315-pound bench press by doing a lot of volume with the 225-pound bench press. That's not how it works. You have to put on the weight. It has to be very challenging. You have to work very close to your max limits for that to happen. A lot of people I've noticed really are not interested in doing that, or they would love to be able to do that, but they don't want to go through the grueling, dangerous route of actually lifting the really heavy weights. It's like Ronnie Coleman said, everybody wanted to get big, but nobody really wanted to lift heavy-ass weights. Well, thank God that I really like doing this. I really enjoy challenging myself. And, you know, I'm always very cautious and very scared when doing these things. It's not like, oh, let's go, you know, do heavy weights and like, yeah, oh, I got a hernia or, you know, I slipped a disc or something. No, you know, I'm always extremely cautious. Now, today I also did the side lateral with the 50 pounds. I'm doing them with 50 pounds. And I keep on receiving comments, lower the weight. I couldn't think of a more backward, you know, suggestion. It's like, no, the purpose is to be able to get really good at that weight. Why would I lower it? Why? Because if I train with 40s, then 50s are going to be better. You know, once I do, you know, I train with 40s for a long time. And now with the 50s, it's challenging. It's like, is this momentum, guys? I'm going to ask you. You're here at a dead stop, and then you do this. You're not controlling the negative for sure, but is this momentum? Like, it's like you're pulling as hard as you can. How can that be momentum? I don't really understand that, and I hear a lot. You're using a lot of momentum, starting from a dead stop, going all the way to the top, trying to hold for a split second, and yeah, it drops down. Not negative is not that important when lifting these heavier or maximal weights. In fact, like for the back row, you don't do negatives. You don't do them. Not with those weights. You're going to get hurt. It's all about the explosive pull and then, you know, controlling the weight so it doesn't just fall. So I'm not doing a Pendlay row, which is like pulling from the ground. I'm still, you know, holding on to the weight above the ground. And then from there, pulling again. So it is still a dead stop, pull. In any case, then from there, went to the triceps. Oh, this is great fun. These semi-skull crushers also get a lot of comments. It's not an isolation move. It's a compound move. You're involving the shoulder girdle, and you're involving the elbow extension. Why is it not so strict or completely strict? First of all, it is very harmful for the elbow joint to do super strict skull crushers with heavy weight. So a little bit more like a pullover movement is in fact legit. And so we're up to 132 pounds. I didn't make a progression. I'm still stuck at 4 reps, but this time it felt a little bit easier than the first time. The bar speed was superior. It was faster. So, you know, once I hit 5 reps, I'll be happy. You know, of course, you know, the idea is to do 8-10 reps with that weight and then, you know, continue piling on more weight, you know, go up to 155 pounds. So this provides like endless opportunity for progression, right? You know, you can always try to get stronger, one more rep. And so, you know, just having a lot of fun with this, what else did we do today? Not ignoring the calves, did the 3 sets, 1 on the seated, 2 on the dumbbell raises, and pretty much the same weights, same reps, just continuing with that particular intensity, particular volume for these 12 weeks. And then from there, we'll assess what happened with the calves. Did they grow? Did they stay the same? Did they have a regression? I mean, what's going on? So we'll check it from there. Calves are very tricky. And so I'm very determined to be very methodical with them and to make proper adjustments when necessary. But to make those adjustments, it has to be like very consistent, the thing that you do, right? You're always doing this week after week, week after week. And then, you know, you can analyze and make decision on how to modify if you want to progress. And also abdominals, not ignoring the abs. I'm on a bulk. I'm trying to gain weight. So we're up to 201, 202 pounds fasted in the mornings after being stuck at 194 for like months. It's like no matter what I ate, what I did, I wasn't gaining weight. The training wasn't doing it. The food wasn't doing it. And then all of a sudden, boom, the weight started going up. So couldn't be happier with that also, with that weight gain, because it's improving my lifts. Like the bench press is getting easier. The back row is getting a lot easier, and so on and so forth. So what else could I mention from this training session? That was it. It's like plenty of energy there for the back row. Can't wait until I hit it again. Obviously trying to progress, just more weight, more reps. And so still have a ways to go on this training block. Halfway there, week six, we'll be starting week six, and it's 12 weeks, so we're halfway there. And everything is on schedule, thank God. Anyways, guys, thank you for joining me and listening to my little rants and explanations of, you know, how I go around doing things. Stay well. Don't copy me. Don't get hurt. This is just for, you know, information and entertainment value. You guys who want to see if I get injured one day, well, may the Lord deliver you into double whatever it is that you desire for me, you know. So I am truly, you know, I appreciate those who are truly concerned, but there's a lot of trolls out there who just want to see what's going to happen. I hope you get entertained and, you know, get some value from it. Anyways, God bless everybody and take care. Thank you.